Hello everyone and welcome to the final game from Swiss from the UK Nationals. I'm Ben and today we have Joe Zimmer on the left, using Barra Kraken we saw in the last video. And on the right we have James from the who won the Bristol Regional using Martel Rose. So you can we're just looking here for setups. And we have Tyene Sand, Desert Scavenger, and a Rose Road. On the other side, we have Fionn and Davos. So, not a brilliant set from Joe, kind of economy wise, but they're two pretty good characters. James, obviously, already having sort of a gold and a reduce is pretty damn good. So, they're just going to look for the first plots. Now, I'd say James is. Very interesting fellow, very nice fellow. He really took people by storm with his sort of Martel Rose deck he won when he won the Bristol Regional, the first regional of the season as well in the UK. So lots of tricks he plays. He taught me a thing or two about how to use Ariane properly. Now, both these chaps have made the cut. They're both 5-0 at this point, so this is just seeing who's going to be the sort of top seeds, King of Swiss. Just a bit of discussion going on there. James just checking a ruling. It's always worth checking it just before you kind of, well, it becomes critical, as I'm sure some of you experienced before. And I must say, James, though, you got some very lovely Dracula's tokens, which I believe you also won from the Bristol Regional. Anyway, first plots are done. Now we've got March the Wall, and we've got Carmichael Westeros. So. You're probably a good choice there from Joe. I probably would march Fionn myself because if Sir Davos gets tears, at least comes back to hand. And with Tyene Sand out, that is quite a possibility. So I didn't quite catch who's going first. So guys, I'd say thanks for the support on this. We've got four more videos after this because we cut the top 16. I'm hoping to keep going out on today. Unfortunately, in the UK, the bank holiday weekend, if you are listening to this when it's released, did throw my agenda off a little bit. If you are listening to this after sort of a few months down the line, this is all in the playlist, so you can go back and watch any of these games. There's 10 games in total from the Nationals. Pretty much all of them are quite close, actually, which makes a nice surprise. Nice change from some of the tournament reports I've done. So looks like James is going first. Does he got King's Road in hand from what we can see there? So yep, pops the King's Road and spends six. Was that? Spends six on Ariane with a dupe. That's not playing normally, see putting Ariane out with dupe because obviously with her ability, you lose it. But can be quite helpful, I guess, if you're lacking a military icon. Knowing how James' decks work, I'm almost surprised we didn't see House Foreign Knight come in to discard Sir Davos. So all 5 gold goes on Melisandre. Imagine, yeah, I can kneel Tyene because you don't want the tears on the stick. So James looking for pre-shange action.
That will be on the post.
He's going for an intrigue, which would be unopposed. Joe probably just trying to get a power for him to steal. With an Iron Mines. Probably not something Joe wants to see disappear this early. So James sitting on 2 gold here. I imagine Joe's probably worried about a Vengeance Viridia, which I would believe. Also, I'm pretty sure Khan wouldn't protect him from, because it's your claim, not your opponent's claim. So entry coming in from Alessandra. Should be unopposed. Now we see a one of right or left. I believe that's left, but I could be wrong. Hopefully that hasn't broken up the Giro, because I'm sure James runs both. So we've got unopposed military, doesn't have vengeance then, so interesting he decided to sit on 2 gold. He also decided not to bring Nymeria in. Or bringing the house out, or bringing the Knight of Flowers there. Okay. I wonder what the thinking was behind that. Because he could have brought the Knight of Flowers into block, and you had still got dominance. I guess you're losing the dupe anyway, but... Oh, Joe's just... I hope Joe runs 2 copies of Crescent, because I dare say he's going to need them in this game. And starts cycling around to the second plot. James is having a little bit of a think. And here we go. We have Noble Cause into trading. And that is always my fear when playing trading. If you hit your opponent's Noble Cause, it kind of just basically feels like you've both played the same plot, you just won initiative. I'm sure I said that before on here. Don't know what you guys think. I'm starting to go off trading. I'm starting to think there's better plots out there to pick. Giving your opponent 3 gold is starting to seem like a bad idea to me. This might be because I'm leaning more now towards playing Martel and Greyjoy again, now that the sort of tournament season's over. And both of those decks don't really want to be giving your opponent more money. 7 gold for Robert Baratheon. So Joe's playing 7 gold. I think we'll see a Bob. Yes, we are. Robert Baratheon. I hear he's pretty good. 2 gold brings in Serene. One of those Barra cards I find incredibly annoying. Okay, James sitting on 9 gold plus 2 reducing, and another King's Road. So James is not hurting for economy in this game at all. So do you think James is putting some money aside? That's a lot of money. It's either for Ariane, because it's 5. Oh no, she's in Lord of Lady, isn't she? So could be seeing a red viper, could we? This would make my day if we saw a red viper. Oh, we've got the Nymeria, because obviously Nymeria's not a... Or... Nope, James has forgotten his Lord or Lady discount then. Because he definitely spent 2 gold on that with the King's Road. Oh, we've got a Marjorie. And sitting on 3. So he played out 8 worth of cards. He had the King's Road. James reminding him that the King's Road needs to be sacrificed, otherwise that'd be an absolutely amazing card. And James is going to hand Judgment that scene in flames. So someone's still going to get knelt, but I'm pretty sure he didn't want his Nymeria getting stolen. Or discarded rather than stolen, I should say. So, Tiny Knelt, which I've got a feeling is going to be a theme for this game. Baratheon absolutely hates his. Is that a put to the sword in James's hand? Is that tears? I think it's a put. We could be about to see a very... That does look like a put to the sword. So we can have a situation here where if Joe's not careful, Robert Braffin might be able to, or Mel might be able to get put to the sword. Especially if he can keep Marjorie standing. Bring Nymeria in with swap Nymeria in, use Marjorie to buff the strength. Takes a Davos's military, and Joe could have been a world of hurt here. You probably had to take a bit of a tempo hit on this turn, let a few characters run wild, but Jay's having a bit of a think.
Military challenge, stealth.
Oof, that's a massive military for Joe. He's gone for such a massive military. Oh, I wonder if he's worried about
and intimidate would be on.
So it goes unopposed. Knight of Flowers is taken as the Duke of Knight of Flowers has taken his claim. And he's kneeling. So at this point, Ariane now, this is where James, if he hasn't actually yet, brings in Nymeria and takes the intrigue icon.
No things for you.
I think he'd said come and take the intrigue icon, but James seems to be having a little think now, which surprises me. So yes, he's told taking the intrigue icon off Melisandre, so that James's last remaining card, or two last remaining cards, which we know one of them is put to the sword, are now safe. So who's he going to put to the sword? James is doing some quick challenge maths in his head. I probably could now kneel Marjorie to defend this.
Yep, four challenges.
Start with military.
Okay, that's unopposed.
So military from the Knight of Flowers. And here's the put to the sword. You'd not normally see this out of... Martel. And James has now got to work out who to kill. He may want to stun the intrigue first, because Nymeria is about to get knelt. So, Mel has taken his claim. So, this game says put to the sword. That was unopposed. And James has forgotten his renown and his unopposed power. And he remembered it there. Obviously, it's always a bit... I do the same. You get a bit excited that you've had to put a put to the sword off. And you kind of forget that there's this whole kind of, you know... power thing that you need to grab. So, yeah, that was a massive play. It's not often you see put to the sword coming out of Martel. So currently at 4-all going into the third plot. Okay, plot's chosen, and we have Song of the Summer into Calling the Banners. So Joe has chosen to go first. Still can't help but feel James should have killed Bob there. I think that was just me. I find him far more annoying than Mel. But can't really argue. James is 5-0 on the day, and he's won a regional, and I haven't, so I wasn't. So. So you've got fiery followers, there's obviously no nil-nil.
Not that you don't have other ways of kneeling stuff, but...
Cards in hand? Three. Probably going to see Aaron.
So the Lord's Port Shipwright, which is assume Joe's put out in case we see Gaston Gray appear. So James got 6 gold, but he's now basically top decking, so this will be interesting to see what he plays out. Marjorie dupe, Tyene dupe, and 5 goals for Ariane. There's no cards left in hand. So, in some ways, it's quite good for Joe, because it means there's no new shenanigans to be had.
You have no actions. Okay, so do I have an action? Yeah.
So, what icon is Nymeria going to steal? Me, I might be tempted to steal Bob's military. Get your board state around. The other option, of course, you go for power. So you can try and get an unopposed power in at the end, especially once you use Davos, but. Rob's military is taken.
No cards in hand.
No cards in hand. No shenanigans.
Intrigue challenge.
It's got intrigue coming in from Law Sport shit right. Which is unopposed, because James has no cards, doesn't care, isn't that much.
Strength 2.
So she made it hard because I had to make sure I had the new gold to play twice. He would go on top of deck, so you see.
Oh, it's top of deck?
Yeah, it's top of deck.
Oh, it's always back to hand.
That's better. Yeah, she's.
Okay, in my head it was better.
So that is much better, actually. Yeah. That is okay. So even on a 5 gold, it's like gold advantage.
Yeah, I okay. Let's start counting the beans. Your strength's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
So James having a bit of a think here. So defends the military with Nymeria.
Sorry,
guys. So Joe's just getting a dice out to remind him of the strength buff for Bob. Currently set at strength 8.
Power challenge,
so Joe going all out again on the challenges. So he defends with, or does he not defend? So what's the issue you have here is you defend, especially against Bob with his Intimidate, you're adding to his strength, so you have to defend someone really big to really get the strength down, stop the Intimidate from going off. But at the same time, you're effectively defending with two people, which then really wrecks your board stakes to the Intimidate. If I was him, yeah, I would let it go unopposed. It's a big power gain for Joe. And he, yeah, he's always going to nil Tyeen. But at least now, as James can get three unopposed challenges back, rack his power up, get renowned on nice flowers. Power I'm assuming? Oh no, that's the intrigue. And a second copy of Maester Crescent. So if there are any milks or icon removal, that's gonna start, that's gonna hurt Joe, I would have thought. Can't see him running more than two copies of him. So unopposed power, and then the Life Flask comes in from unopposed military. And who's Joe gonna take his claim?
I think it's the
I think it's Davos, bring him back to hand. Dominance goes to Joe, the Fiery Follower would have stood anyway, so I think it definitely dominance to Joe. And there we are, sat at... I think they get tie dominance. Joe's got Fiery Followers. So currently sat at, I believe, 8 all. James having another big think. So guys, if you are sort of catching this and you want to get any more updates, obviously we've got the top 16 games coming in, so if you subscribe you'll be notified of any games that of the games as they come out. So yeah, but if you want to keep up to date, want to know what's going on, then that's probably like the best way to do it, and help support the channel. Doesn't cost you anything. So all my scrubs, I do appreciate it, so thank you very much. Just like appreciate people let me record their games so I can bring them to you. But we've now got an interesting turn here. So Joe's flipped Wildfire into the old 2K first Winds of Winter, I want to say. So that was an interesting choice. The Knight of Flowers and there's my brain's gone. I've had an absolute brain fart. I've had a pretty intense day recording. The Knight of Flowers and Marjorie, there we go, taken as for Wildfire. So it'll be interesting to see what James can do for this two claim plot, especially now Bob's got a dupe. That's going to be annoying. So you get one gold for the Devil Scavenger, and then he passes.
So you got one card in hand, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, no actions from me. Any actions?
I don't think we're playing for standings. We're playing for honor. We're playing for who can go undefeated.
You're going to be.
Thanks again, man.
I must say, at this point, Joe's board position is looking pretty strong. Especially that Knight of Flowers gone, there's no natural military icons on James's side.
I know,
this is the most part, but mine is in mint condition because it's never. I think probably I should have kept the Knight of Flowers until now.
just assume you play cards. I've somehow got 5-0. Just for reference.
Just as bad as we deserve this pass.
Okay.
This is why we're in the cup.
There you go.
Now is the time.
Thanks for playing, Matt.
Well done. Well done.
So Lord George Shipwreck comes in for an entry challenge. And Jay is worried about what that one card in hand is.
I'm pretty sure,
your model bit. So that puts me out in between 5 and 4. Boom! Get wrecked on that.
Oh, is that 5? Who's on that? Aria Hota 5.
And a full defend. I wonder if he possibly has Hotar, because this is a matchup when Hotar really comes into it. Because if Joe comes in for a bit with Bob for his big challenge to nail someone, Hotar comes in and just boots him out of the challenge. No intimidate, no renowned, no power, and then especially the 2 claim plot out. Very easy for James to take advantage of that and start whittling down that board state. So we've got big military coming in there from Bob and the fiery followers. Unopposed. Interesting, James seems pretty nonchalant about that. And no claims, so what is that card in hand? Stealthing
over to you.
So Joe's now up to 12 power. What is it?
A power challenge. Thank you.
So power coming in from Devil Scavenger, which would be 3 power, 2 for claim, 1 for the unopposed.
It's worth me just letting
you through.
Great players, you have 20
minutes left. 20 minutes in the round. So, claim of 2. So, Davos comes back to hand and.
Unopposed.
Oh, that card in hand was Pyromancer's. Which is interesting. But it was coming for an unopposed intrigue, and James is currently at 10 power. And James gets dominance, so he's up to 11 power to Joe's 10 power. That's quite strong, that 2 claim plot doing some work for James there. I guess what Joe did need himself out, but I guess you kind of might as well, because if he had left Sir Davos standing, he was just going to have his power icon stolen most likely. And Joe's board state looking pretty small. And also losing Ash and the newly made Lord for claim. If James does get a Gaston Grey out, that's going to... Losing that newly made Lord's going to be a pain in the backside. And he's already lost the Lord Port ship, right?
sat here staring at Gaston going.
Another bit of think here on the plots.
Right. Flash.
I thought so.
I will be going first because I have to do this now.
We have summons into a Clash of Kings. So James clearly looking for some sort of character. Clash of Kings is an interesting choice there, Budge, because it's not going to be too hard for James just to steal the power icon off Big Bob. And then Joe's going to struggle to win those power challenges.
Oh, sorry, that's my hand. I can show you, because you know it's Ariane. So I'm proving it's my hand. I'm like, ah, I've got them leveled up.
So James is saying he's mixed up his hand a little bit there with the cards he's thinking about for summons, so just showing obviously we know Ariane's in hand because that's where he jumped back in for the Pyromancers, and he is the only genie. He only had one card in hand. So you've got a House Floor and Knight picked as picked for the summons. James has a lot of good work with. I imagine it's going to be Sir Davos again.
Haven't had an econ on James doing a big problem. Haven't had an econ all game.
Yeah. James complains had no econ all game, and that is very noticeable. I think Barra get in particular get really hurt by the lack of econ. I don't know, it's just my experience of playing Barra, but I always find I seem to be light on cash as it is. So you've got a King's Road, pops the King's Road after having just complained he has no econ, he finds some econ. And gets Sir Davos back out. So he should be on 2 gold left. And 2 gold for Mr. Windermere. So there was my worry that Joe wouldn't have a power icon on Big Bob, and he probably still won't, but Joe's more than made up for it with Sir Davos and Mr. Windermere to come in with their stealth and power. So what's James going to spend with his 5 gold? Assumed he would see Ariane back out and play.
I'd have tried. You get the other post.
Yeah, no, I'd try.
I expected you to actually just let it down.
No, because you're at 12 now.
Yeah, that's
so,
true, I guess.
If I didn't win this turn, then I'm never going to come back.
You need to get five power to win this
turn. Dominance was a draw.
An intrigue challenge, a power challenge will get you one for winning the power challenge, another one for winning the power challenge, and one for amateurs if it's unfair. So that will get you two.
So James just planning out his gold a little bit. I think he's also just working out if Joe is, he's just working out the power challenge, how much power Joe will be on. So what he needs to oppose, what characters he needs to get out.
Thank you.
So is he 5 gold? And Ariane now. He's not knelt the Devil Scavenger. I'm assuming that's so he can has one more power icon to block the unopposed from the power challenge. And he's duping Ariane. Probably not a bad choice right now, because he can't really afford to take a Devil Scavenger's claim.
Am I going to steal Bob's power?
James is the one who got power icon steal. I personally think he... The problem is you don't steal Bob's power. If you steal Bob's power, then there's no military, so that'd be an unopposed power for military, assuming nothing can jump in. Although he's got House for a Knight in hand, that would discard James' own Devil Scavenger.
I was hoping you'd do that.
So an unopposed military, power for, 2 power for claim because of Clash of Kings and Renowned on Bob's, so that'd be 4 power. That would leave Joe 1 short, plus an Intimidate to go off. Yeah, James got to be really careful here, otherwise he could end up losing it this turn.
I might be wrong. 15 minutes left on the round. 15 minutes. I might as well think this through. I'm just trying to... I was just like, there's so many options. Oh, no, I'm not just about to win. I need 4. 2 of those.
And other ways that you might not want to give Nymeria, take an ice carny out of Nymeria, because just having the threat of her saying there means she has to be stealthed.
Okay. So I can't win this turn. It's not, I'm not going to pull that through. So
we're going for the full 6-0 sweep.
A bit of a mix-up there, because James didn't put his power with the other power he needed to get. So yeah, when the Knight of Flowers was killed, he put 2 of the power off the bat, so he thought he needed 2 more power to win. So at the moment, he's still winning. That's 11-10. James is taking no actions. Jade's really thinking about this, and makes sense to at this point. He may want to think about trying to win a power on defence. So he's still another power, and that would probably win him the game if he could. So you've got a massive power coming in. Oh, well, not massive, but currently his power is 7, 6, sorry, 8, not 8 power. Stealthing.
I was considering, actually, Chudrock.
Stealthing Amiri, and the Devil Scavenger comes into Chudrock. So he still wins by 8. Here's where Joe's superior came and wins, which he doesn't. So Joe's now on 13 power. So he's going to intimidate. This stage, do you intimidate Nymeria? Stop her from doing your challenge at will. Oh, sorry, guys.
Yeah.
I should probably just gone for board presence earlier. I still think I forgot to.
I won't say there's any.
I think you might.
Yeah. Because I was like, wait a minute.
Just make sure it's in order.
Okay. I was like, so he loses his icon because I'm playing Martel.
So he intimidates the pyromancers. That's interesting. So just a bit of discussion there about whether they're doing an action or not. So Syria jumps in, which is interesting, to oppose the military challenge there from Sir Davos. So what do you do next? So I think you need to a power challenge because you need to take a power off Joe just to bring him a bit further away from victory. And then do you come in and tears someone? So that's unopposed, bringing James back up to 10. And Jay kills the 5 followers. Nope. I think Jay, you need them for dominance. I'd have thought. Very tempted to do the team with the sort of tiers play. I think you've got to do the power. Yes, 2 power. It brings 2 power. So Joe, if he remembers, is going to get dominance. Yes, he does. So two more power for Joe and three more power for James to win the game. Joe's double checking what plots he's seen. Which kills the pyromancers for James's sound effects. Which I think is about to come into a... And here, Confiscate gets flipped into the side, which does nothing. I think James has picked himself to go first. Now we could see this could be a quite easy close out at this point. With the ability of Sirius give another character stealth. They may strip an icon. And let's not forget there's also that House Flora Knight still in hand that we've not seen. There could be some... a few pretty strong plays coming in here from James. Comes in. Right. I want to say, considering Joe's basically no economy, that one Rose Road has done a load of work for James in this game. He's been able to keep funding Ariane. So Nymeria's milked. That's going to be annoying. Lightbringer on Bob. And over to James. So. What I want to do here. Do you do a military Assyrio stealthing past Bob to try to force the other two to kneel out and then do an unopposed intrigue and unopposed power? Using getting the unopposed power with Assyrio giving stealth to someone? I think that wins you the game. Double checking what the sword attachment does. Lightbringer. It's very annoying. Especially on Bob. Say the players have just talked about it's easy enough saying it from here on the sideline, but when you're there in the moment trying to get 6-0 in the tournament, it's a little bit harder. But I do think Sirio still past Bob. Joe has to kneel to defend. If he kneels out, then you've got unopposed challenges and you win the game. The thing is, you have to stealth past Bob because of his renowned and Lightbringer. Oh, okay. So it brings Ariane into play to discard the Fiery Followers.
No, that doesn't count. You're right.
Unseen in Flames. Right. No,
Okay.
Oh, and that actually stops. Oh, that stops Joe from doing a Scene in Flames play. Because he's lost a Relore character. So James in the verse. I don't know if James meant to do that. It looks by reactions he didn't. But he's now taken out.
Free power to get.
The possibility of Joe to be able to defend that. So Siri comes in for a military stealthing Bob. I've got to think this is all she wrote. Has Joe got any tricks left up his sleeve? Unopposed. That is risky. So, yeah. Good team stuff. And Joe calls the game. Well played, both of you. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Come back next for the top 16 games and we'll get into the cuts.